Welcome back to the South Main Auto Channel. So I got a fresh one off the hook, 2004 Honda Civic. It's got the 1.7 in it, got a couple hundred thousand miles on it. The young lady who owns it was on her way here to get a new battery. That's the battery charger on it. And she stopped at the old Dunkin' Donuts and it conked out on her in the drive-thru. The car cranks okay. She did have somebody try to assist her to get it running and jump started, but to no avail. So we have a crank, no start, and we're gonna check it out and see what's going on. So inside the car here, we'll give her a crank. We got nothing. However, we're gonna give her a little toot on the throttle here. So it does start and run. Running pretty choppy, then it dies if you let it idle. So I'll try to back off the throttle. Of course, there's no tag, so you can't really see it, but see if it'll idle on its own. All right, so it is idling, very, very rough. So we can see and possibly hear that the engine is running pretty choppy. Probably hear it better on the exhaust, I imagine. All right, so you get an idea of how it's running. So went ahead and plugged the Autel in. This is all we have for codes. The monitors are complete, even though the battery's been dead. So the entire drive cycle's run. This is all we have for codes. If we give it some throttle, it runs decent. You know, runs pretty well. Just idling is where we have the issue. And there it stalls. So it's at this point, I really don't know where to take the video. Experience tells me what's wrong with this car. And the car is running like it's got a stuck EGR valve. Anybody who's done any kind of EGR testing on cars, particularly cars with a MAP sensor, now this car uses speed density as opposed to a mass airflow system. So when the EGR valve opens, manifold pressure drops, car runs crazy rich, you know, has all the inert gas in there and, you know, runs like crap. However, you raise the RPMs and, you know, away you go. So I think what we can do is, you know, we can verify that. We'll look at some scan data, you know, see if that's true. See, you know, is it running rich? Do we have, you know, some kind of EGR feedback? You know, why doesn't it set an EGR code if that's the case? You know, that stuff I don't know yet. We know the car has, you know, fuel pressure. We know it has injector pulse. We know it has spark. We know it has compression. And judging by the way it runs revved up, we know that the timing is likely not off. Mechanical timing, you know, as far as the belt's concerned. To get an engine running, fuel, spark, compression, you know we need all of those items. We also need, the engine needs the ability to breathe. So what's the old saying, you know, suck, squeeze, bang, boom. You know, it's how four stroke works. If we don't have any sucky, we don't have any bangy, you know, and that's just the way it goes. So what we could do is old school, we could grab our vacuum gauge and see what our cranking vacuum is. I would expect on an engine that cranks, you know, rapidly, a couple hundred RPMs, to see, you know, somewhere between 3 and 5 inches of vacuum. So that's something we could do too. And that's something you could do, you know, if you don't have data to look at. You know, a car cranks, I mean, you got a spark, you got compression, you got everything that technically should make it run. So let's do that. But first, we and I were sitting right here, we'll look at some data. See if we can't get it running again. So I'll keep the car running this way here, because if you crank it while you're trying to do this, it you know, it tends to reset my scan tool. See if I can get it back to an idle. I'll let the idle air control valve take over while the data is loading up here. Oh, shimo, baby. Okay, did not reset our scan tool. Let me set you guys down here. All right, see if we can do this. We'll grab, and of course, you know, we're looking through this, we'll scan other PIDs, you know, coolant temp. So we got RPM, coolant temp looks good, intake looks good. Grab our map sensor voltage. Our barrel looks good. Throttle position is working. Grab our AFR. Grab our downstream O2. We got EGR. All right, so everything else appears fine. And honestly, we don't have to go super far. So we've got our EGR lift command is at zero, and it appears our feedback is at 3.8 millimeters of lift. So in this particular situation, it's pretty cut and dry. You know what? Well, we could grab our fuel trims too. We can see the engine's probably running quite rich here. Our rear O2 is pretty high. Trying to get the thing to idle here. Come on, little guy. But look at our map sensor. You know, we've got elevated voltage on our map sensor. Yeah, I can't make the thing idle. But at any rate, you know, we see our EGR valve on this one. It's interesting though that it did not or does not throw a EGR code. Let's see here. Oh, here comes Mrs. O. What's up? Okay. All right. Okay. All right, folks. We'll be right back. Okay, I'm back off the phone. Trying to do a couple things at once here. I pulled up some generic data for us. This way here, we got some fuel trends that we're all accustomed to seeing. And we'll see what the fuel trends are. I expect them to be quite negative, personally. Let's see here, we got it. Oops, whoa, crap. There we go. So now we're in closed loop. We can see our short-term fuel trim is at minus 32. Let's get it revved up here. Should get a little better as we increase RPM. Yeah, a little bit better, but if that EGR valve stuck a long ways open, then our manifold pressure is going to be way off. Come back down to an idle or near idle. Come on, little guy. Yeah, that's kind of what I was expecting to see. All right, let's go out under the hood. All right, so anyhow, I hope we're all kind of following along at this point. And I'll be honest, sometimes I don't know what direction to take videos if I already, you know, have a good inclination as to what's going on with the car. And like I say, this one is just, you know, just experience based. When I, you know, the rollback dropped it off, went out, cranked it, give a little gas, started, you know, ran like garbage on an idle, you know, first thing came to my mind, you know, EGR valve. And knowing that these are a MAP engine, it really screws with them. Now, it doesn't screw with a mass airflow engine as much fuel trim wise, because they work a little different. But on a MAP engine, it really raises cane with them. So what we're gonna do, just kind of proof of concept perhaps, you know, before and after fix, you know, and again, I don't know what's wrong with EGR valve, if it has something jammed in it or if it's just, you know, physically stuck open, what the deal is. But we're gonna find some place to grab manifold vacuum. We're gonna crank the engine just for the heck of it, see what it is, and then we're gonna take a peek at that EGR valve. It's pretty easy to get to, see what ails it, and then redo our test after it's fixed. We need an assistant.
Where's Hannah?
You missed. Come on, pick it up. You're like the children, I gotta keep telling you.
Thanks.
Right, you coming?
I'm going.
Come on, jump back, jump. We're in the middle of a lesson.
A lesson?
Yes.
Who's learning?
The people.
You're not learning? Aren't you always learning?
I am.
Okay.
All right, what do you think's wrong with this car? What's your guess?
What are the symptoms?
Crank, no start, unless you give it some throttle.
God, that stinks.
Smells good out here, don't it?
No.
Yummy. Yes, we need you in the car. Don't touch the gas pedal when you crank it, though, okay? All right, Miss O, crank your little heart out. Whoa! Am I on the right side of this? Let's see. I unhooked the purge solenoid. Oh, you dummy. I'm on the wrong side of the purge solenoid. All right, take two. Alright, we're hooked up to the right spot. Yeah, I was on the wrong side of the purge solenoid because I didn't pay attention in a big hurry. I knew it couldn't be that easy. So I have to put that metal clip back on. Anyhow, we're actually hooked to manifold vacuum now. You ready, Mrs. O? Hey, quit snooping.
What? There's nothing in here to look at.
Oh, okay. Alright, just telling you.
No.
Alright, crank it. See, I'm watching the camera. So what'd that go to again? Go ahead and crank it again. Oh, she wanted it. Okay, that's good. Whoa! Easy there, killer.
You're talking to me.
No. No, I'm talking to the people. All right, so we can see as Mrs. O was cranking there, we only got up to about maybe 2.5 inches of vacuum, and it really wanted to start there. Like I say, somewhere between 3 and 5 is probably good. But what we're going to do now is come over here to the EGR valve, which lives right there. Looks relatively easy to take off. We're going to zip that off all zippy-zap-like and see what ails it.
Are you done with me?
Yes, I am. Not forever, but for now. So I'm hoping I can get in there with a 10-millimeter scroll. Of course, it is not even 10 millimeter. Let's try 12. A lot of take twos in this video. All right, I'm hoping to get in there with a 12 millimeter swivel. Oh, she's tight. Oh, I dude didn't even want you to let these little guys. Up. Oh, mother lover. Let me get a magnet because you know something's going to drop. Stud came out of that one. No big deal. Oh man. Wait till you folks see this. Let me get her propped up. Classic, baby, classic. I think we made the right call. So we can see on our little EGR valve, the pinel is stuck way open, but wait till you see why. Look at that. She's got one little chunko carbon, I call it, stuck in the pinel. What are the odds of that? In the Dunkin' Donuts drive-thru, on the way to SMA, boom, piece of carbon. Unbelievable. Let's get some surgical tools. And by surgical tools, I mean pocket screwdriver. That was it. Now she's back shut. She just had a little carbon is off. What do you expect for 200,000 miles? Well, what are the odds of a little piece wedging in there? And I'm wondering if we took and commanded the EGR valve open and then closed again, it probably would have fell out. But what kind of video would that be? What lessons would we have learned? So I'll make sure there's nothing else stuck on there. Oh, get a hold of that, you little guy. So we can see the little tiny scrape marks on the edge of that pinel where the carbon was, but it is no longer. Well, I'll be jiggered. So no need for a new EGR valve as of right now. Well, just when you think you've seen it all, I've never seen that before. I've seen EGR valves bad, I've seen pinels stick. Can't say I've ever seen one little piece of crust hold it open though. Alrighty, well let's stick it back on. I put the stud back in there. Now we're gonna have to get these nuts back on without dropping them. Let me get a piece of napkin here. That trick my grandmother taught me. Take your little napkin and stick it under the nut and now it won't fall off. So I'm gonna have to lift up the valve, get it started. Wiggle that back off. Do the same thing on the other one, then we'll jam them down to factory spec. And then I'm kind of curious to see what the cranking vacuum is going to be. So that way there we've got a definitive number. I expect it to get up around 5 or so. Of course, now the vehicle's gonna start, so we're gonna need to disable something, fuel, perhaps, pull the fuse out of it. Pull the EFI fuse out of a Honda. I think it's going to be a loud crank, but it'll kill spark, kill spark and injector pulse. Go factory spec. Everything looks good. Let's see if it runs. Shimon, we got her done. We got her done.
What do you
need for? We need to finish our testing.
I thought you said we're done.
Well, we got it running. All right, Shimon. You're not even like remotely impressed. And we got it fixed.
That's what you do.
Yeah, but shouldn't you be like, man, I can't believe you fixed that in like a minute, man.
Wow, that's amazing.
Yeah, I'm not even buying it. All right, let's see. We need to find something that's gonna make this little guy not run.
Show me something here, little fella. Coming through fans. Is there anything here? Ignition. Oh, that's a jumbo head. Fogger. Ooh, there we go. What's this? FIECU. 15 amp. Is that one? I think it's that one. Will it start? Negative. Shut her down. Okay. All right, folks. Let's see what we got. All right, Mrs. L, crank it. All right. Okay, just a minute. Let me get steady. Okay, do her again. All right. So, what were we pulling there? Hit me one more time. All right. Okay, kind of. I'm just a little shocked at our... Hey, quit spying on people.
I was picking up the quarter on the board with
your chain. Oh, okay. Yeah, right. You're probably in there filling your pockets, Mrs. O. Busted. This is like one of those things that Jiffy Lube place, you know, exposed.
Well, that's why I don't know if that's...
Yeah, we just exposed you.
Anyhow, I take everything out of my car.
Before you go to the shop?
Shops work.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we just wipe out your change container.
Or at least... Look at everything.
Well, of course you look at stuff. You're sitting in the car.
Well,
you can learn a lot about a person by sitting in their car. The smells, the sights.
You know things by the way they smell?
Yes.
I don't want to know.
Yes, you probably don't. Anywho, what did we find? So I think before we had about 2.5 inches. This time we're creeping up on 4. So we're kind of right at that threshold as to, you know, the no start situation, but... give us one more crank there, Mrs. O. Yes. All right. Dang, I wish we could stick the EGR valve back open. So I knew, you know.
It's not open now?
No, it's fixed now. Kidding me?
Now, what are you going
to
do now?
Nothing. We got to wrap up the video and put the hose back on, call the customer. Tell her that we worked on it for 8 hours straight.
Wait, what? You said it was fixed now?
It's fixed now, yeah.
And then a no start?
No, I did. It's disabled, so we can check cranking back in. Don't you watch our channel? Sheesh.
I live it.
You live it, man. All right, crank it up just so you know for your own well-knowing.
Ah, you're amazing.
Oh, thank you, thank you.
Good?
Kill it. All right, Mrs. O's back in the office, done harassing us. I'm going to pull up our data. We're also going to have to find the code for the radio. So, life hack. I'll show you a Honda trick life hack. Let me set you folks down here. In case you don't know and you own a Honda and you've lost your code, pretty simple to get back. So you're going to press 1 and 6, hit the power button, hit it again. It's going to give you your serial number. Should be a 8-digit code, U and a L. Yep. So there's your 8-digit code. You can log online to Honda's website, put in your email address, put in your serial number, get the code. Man, it's like Free Tip Friday already, and it's only Monday. So what do we want? We were looking at our fuel trims, manifold pressure. We'll just look at this real quick. Fire it up. We'll let it go in a closed loop. Of course, it didn't seem to change any of the long term, so it should. I took the battery charger off, and shoot, we're gonna have to wait for this to reconnect. Our data's gonna be all mixed up here. Yeah, when your cranking voltage gets low, it resets our scan tool and raises all kinds of heck with them here. So you can see we got 0 RPMs. Locks it all up. So we're in a closed loop. What do we want? Short term, long term. Let's see what else we want. It's manifold pressure. She's still got she's got a little fuel trim correction there. About 10%. Getting close to it anyways. We'll let it run here a little bit and warm up. See where it ends up. Total fuel trim. Definitely a heck of a lot better than we were, I'll tell you that. Manifold pressure looks good. The rear O2 is calming down here a little. Of course, she probably got a lot of fuel in her right now. Our equivalency ratio on our front sensors look good. We're going to see that around 1. Pop in, what we'll do is we'll pop in, we'll take a peek at some OEM and look at that EGR valve lift again. I'll let this get loaded up here. Alright, so here we're back to where we started. We got our EGR valve command 0 and our EGR valve lift is at 0 millimeters. And we can see our voltage is back down. So like I said, and this car is pretty cut and dry, you know, if you kind of knew what the symptom was, and you know, we were fortunate enough to have some data pits to look at. However, no codes for direction, but you know, you could quickly make that assessment. We can see our fuel trim's still, we're about 5% short term, 4% long term. So perhaps the engine does have a slight lean drivability. I know prior to this, it's never had any codes in it, so as long as it's in fuel control, we're happy. Our map sensor is back down under a volt at idle. Well, yee-haw! I think, perhaps, there is an EGR valve test. Pulled her open. And we can see our EGR valve lift is at 3.18 volts, so she's open quite a ways there. Make sure it snaps back shut here. Yeah, we can see it did. It went back shut. Oh, look at that. Test finished. Sweet. All right, folks, that's that. There's nothing more to see here. So now we can put the battery in it like the girl was originally on her way to SMA4. She'll be happy. And she'll be happy to know it was a quick fix. You know, I mean, this is gravy diagnosis. You know, pretty quick in and out. Nothing, no parts required. And that's always a cool thing for the customer. That is, and you know, for us to wait on anything. I know she's on her way back to work and all that stuff, so that can be helpful. But in regards to the symptoms, you know, if you get a vehicle in that it's a crank, no start, and you've got everything else, you know, compression and spark and fuel pressure, and you just don't know why, cranking vacuum, you know, be sure to check cranking vacuum. Now, this one we only deviated probably, you know, maybe an inch and a half of vacuum from bad to good. But you got to remember, when it was bad, it really wanted to start. So, you know, perhaps maybe this wasn't 100% the best example. And of course, we had scan data to kind of back up our thoughts and feelings on, you know, just the way the car ran. Now, it's not always just an EGR valve. Keep in mind, too, I guess probably the best way to put it is if the engine can't breathe, you know, if you got spark, compression, fuel, everything, and the engine can't breathe, you know, example, plug catalytic converter, you know, you're going to be in the same symptom, and that will also decrease manifold, you know, pressure too, you know, as far as your cranking vacuum. So keep that in mind. We need more than spark, fuel, and compression. We need the ability of the engine to breathe. We need biometric efficiency, I guess. That's not the right term. But anyhow, thanks for checking out the video. Be sure to check us out on Facebook, Google Plus, and now on Patreon. I'll put links here up on the video. I'll put them in the description box. You can check them out there. And just remember, viewers, if I can do it, you can do it. Thanks for watching.